In the year 2001, the BBC sent award-winning journalist Chris Webster Smith to spend a day with a cult, calling themselves the PCC. Prevent cruelty to crayons. This is his story.
So could you tell us a little bit about the company, guys?
Yeah, I got... Are you alright? Is he alright?
If we... Yeah, right, basically the company, PCC...
No, I was going to tell him. I'm telling him.
He's asked us both and you were slow, so... But basically, PCC,
no,
right, prevent cruelty.
No, because you never let me talk.
Alright, you tell him then. Go on, what have you got? He's got nothing.
I'm just head of security, mate. You better tell him, but I'm supervising.
As I thought. PCC, prevent cruelty... Oh, tell him about the badge.
I've got a badge.
He's got a badge, right?
I have got a badge, right? There it is.
Who gave you the badge?
My granddad gave me this badge, you're right?
Yeah,
I love my granddad. He's my granddad.
He's dead now.
Why have you said that? Why?
Got run over by an ice cream van, so... Says a lot about the man.
Why did I say that?
All he wanted was a Canetto.
Calippo Uber.
Well, Canetto. Huh?
Sensitive.
I'm not insensitive. I'm not saying sorry, but look me in your eyes. I'm sorry, right? You tell the man about the company.
Okay, this company basically, right? PCC.
Yeah.
Prevent cruelty crayons. And that
on
is.
On a summer's all day, cool your head, Calypso fun. Granddad's dead. Huh? It's a joke I play. I'm playing, Wealth. Well, I'm only joking! I've got one for you as well!
Later that evening, the PCC arrived back from a raid, but Fahud is visibly upset.
Look at that, right? That really brings a tear to my eyes, right? That one's been broke. That one's dead. That one's crippled. That one's been snapped. That one's got meningitis. So, what kind of a man does this? I'll tell you what kind of a man does it. Mr. Thomas, local vicar, yeah? Found these in his house, right? You think it's hard abusing crayons, don't you, Mr. Thomas? You think I'm impressed? I'm not impressed. I tell you it is hard, right? Chewing on razor blades, that's hard.
I'm clever.
Well, it's not clever, because they could be children watching and cut your throat and...
The vicar, Mr. Thomas, you can't say his name.
But Mr. Thomas had the crayons.
Yeah, but no, but you can't say that because he runs a parish. People trust him. Old people trust him. If they found that out about him before he was convicted, they wouldn't like him. You didn't have to change that.
He doesn't mind being filmed.
Well, actually, I do mind.
Oh, he does.
For legal reasons, during filming, Mr. Thomas's face and voice had to be disguised.
Joking around going, Shadwell, oh god, you're like Mr. Motivator. But I'm like, no, how that wouldn't look at it.
Huh?
Like, what?
More like Mr. Muscle. Huh? What? Nothing. Little game I've had to play.
An hour later, while the team are having a tea break, we see Bafakad's anger problem surface.
Guys, we've got another raid. What's he still doing here?
I'm a cup of tea.
Wait, Shadwell, what's the meaning of this?
He's thirsty.
He's a crayon abuser! No, Mr. Thomas! No! Out! Now!
But, disguise your voice.
Yeah!
Whilst filming, the PCC hear news of a snap crayon in the local area. But Fahud makes the decision to raid the house. He invites our cameras along for the ride.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Right, we're here, outside. Outside. Little trick for you. Apparently,
One in five people, innit? Know somebody called either Lucy
right.
or David.
Oh, who is it?
Sarah.
Oh, hello, Sarah. I'm just going to turn now. I'm fine.
After raiding the wrong house, the PCC, Pafakud, Wilf and Shadwell insist we keep the cameras rolling.
Well, I'm disappointed. I mean, where's that present come from? Right, take that back for a start, because that's cheating. You know, people look at me and they say, oh, you've got an easy job. Huh? It's not easy. Gets violent sometimes. I mean, I've been known to slap the odd pensioner for mouthing off,
what?
So not your granddad.
What did you want to say that?
I've never had a problem with your granddad's granddad.
No,
me and your granddad, we used to have karaoke lessons and...
Let's just go.
Oh, well.
Let's go this way.
Can't believe it.
Where's that dog come from?